Welcome to the Logic Videos. I'm Scott Aiken.
You are you.
These are videos for the Logic class. This particular video is going to be a video about how to translate conditionals in natural language as conditionals in propositional logic. Got a couple up here. Let's get to work on them. So, if something's a triangle, it's a polygon. If claims go in the antecedent of conditionals, then claims go in the consequent. So if something's a triangle, then it's a polygon. So T, horseshoe, P. Triangle, horseshoe, polygon. So far, so good. That's a familiar conditional. How about this one, though? Something's a triangle only if it's a polygon. Now, if claims go in the antecedent, but do only if claims go in the antecedent? The answer is no. Only if claims go in the consequent of conditionals. Why? Because what an only if claim is like that it works like a prerequisite. It works like something that says, in the same way in which I might say something like, you graduate only if you take a writing class. That doesn't mean that if you take a writing class that you graduate. That doesn't mean that. It means that it works like a kind of a thing that I know that if you're graduating, I know that you took a writing class. Why? Because you graduate only if you take a writing class. So, triangle only if polygon, only if claims go in the consequent. So, T, horseshoe, P. All right, well, how about this one? Only if polygon, then triangle. Well, those are the same words. Is it the same proposition? They're just mixed up. Only if, we took the only if claim here and we put it at the beginning of the sentence. Well, as it turns out, just like it doesn't matter where the if claim comes in the sentence, so I could say something like polygon if triangle, same thing. Notice here, polygon if triangle, if claims go in the antecedent, regardless of wherever they are in the sentence. If they come at the beginning of the sentence, go in the antecedent. If the if claim comes at the end of the sentence, goes in the antecedent. Doesn't matter where it comes in the sentence, matters that it's an if clause. So, triangle, horseshoe, polygon. Why? Because that's an if claim. Well, the same thing goes with only ifs. If it's an only if claim, where does it go? Consequent. So, only if claim goes in the consequent. So far, so good. We got some T, horseshoe, P's. Look at all the ways that you can say T, horseshoe, P. That, again, is the reason why we make the distinction between sentences and propositions. Same proposition, four different sentences. Let's take a look at these guys over here. Being a triangle is sufficient for being a polygon. Okay, so what exactly is a sufficient condition? Well, a sufficient condition is something that says, anytime that you've got one of these things, you're gonna get one of these things. The sufficient condition is the thing, is, you might say, the guaranteeing thing. So you know that if you get the guaranteeing thing, the thing that's sufficient, it will be sufficient for the thing that it guarantees. So a sufficient condition works like an if clause. So, whatever is a sufficient condition. A triangle is sufficient. If it's sufficient, it goes in the antecedent. Whatever it's sufficient for, goes in the consequent. Okay, so far so good. So sufficient conditions go antecedents. Is there another thing that identifies a consequent? Yes, necessary conditions. So, being a polygon is necessary for being a triangle. Necessary conditions work just like those only if claims, or work like those prerequisites. You can graduate only if you take a writing class. A writing class is a necessary condition for graduating. Being a polygon is a necessary condition for being a triangle. That means that if you're graduating, I know you took a writing class. That means if it's a triangle, that given the fact that it having many sides is a condition, a necessary condition for it having three sides, I know that the necessary condition goes in the consequent. And whatever it's necessary for goes in the antecedent. So what do we see here? We see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ways to say exactly the same conditional. If claims, only if claims, various representations or orderings of only if, ifs and only ifs, and a whole bunch of ways to be able to say necessary and sufficient conditions. That now gives us an occasion to represent the anatomy of a conditional. So Here's our conditional, P horseshoe Q. There's our antecedent. Here is our consequent. So far, so good. And notice, by the way, that we get ifs and thens. We have only ifs. We can also have sufficient conditions and necessary conditions. Many, many different ways to be able to say what the conditional relation is between those relevant propositions. In the next video, we're going to be talking about how to say disjunction, not just in terms of the inclusive disjunctions, but also the exclusive disjunctions, and also how to say neither.